Hey there Maharanis, it's Poonam here from the Maharani Diaries and welcome to my channel. In case you missed my very first video, you can catch up on that now in the description below. Before I dive into this week's topic, I'd love for you to hit that subscribe button if you want to see me here every week. Give this video a thumbs up if you love it and let me know in the comments below what you thought and what your biggest takeaways were. So for today's video, I'm going to run through the 10 things no one tells you about planning an Indian or South Asian wedding. Number one, the hidden costs. What many couples aren't aware of before planning their wedding are the many hidden costs that come along with planning every single occasion. And I'm not talking about the wedding and reception. I'm talking about all those pre-wedding events leading up to your wedding day. There are multiple pre-wedding events, such as the engagement, the sangeet, the haldi, or the various pujas or religious ceremonies that take place depending on your background or your traditions. This means you are going to want to have enough food for those interstate or overseas relatives that are coming to stay with you. You may need to account for rentals such as furniture hire or any decorative elements that you need for your pre-wedding events. You also need to ask yourself if there are any transportation costs such as limousine transfers, car hire or bus rentals. So when you work on your budget, think of every single thing that you need to account for. Number two, everybody has an opinion. What you may not realize is when you're planning your wedding, a lot of the stress comes from other people. Everyone wants to be involved and have their say, whether it's good or bad. It could come from your family or your friends or even your parents. Now, some of these opinions may actually be helpful. Best thing here is to listen and just keep calm. You don't want to be alienating anyone at this important time. You never know when you may just need their help. Number three, intimate weddings do not exist. The concept of having less than 100 people at your Indian or South Asian wedding, it very rarely ever exists. And the next couple of points are kind of going to touch on why. Number four, parents' involvement. This is the best day ever for your parents. Finally, they see you getting married off. Out of sincere love, they want to see you just be really happy on your wedding day and make sure that everything goes well for you. Your parents will want to start off with planning the all-important wedding guest list. Your parents will want to invite everyone that they know, and it's going to be like a reunion for them. It's hard to tackle this issue as my husband and I also faced similar problems when we were planning our wedding. It all comes down to being able to compromise and sit down with your parents and just have a conversation. It really doesn't hurt to let your parents have a win every now and again. After all, you are where you are in your life because of your parents. Number five, collecting RSVPs is going to be a challenge. I know this doesn't just apply to Indian or South Asian weddings, but it applies to weddings as a whole, in fact. Not every guest is going to RSVP on time. It's a huge challenge to keep on top of, but make sure you have your Excel spreadsheets ready so as the RSVPs are rolling in, you can keep track of them straight away. It might also be worthwhile setting up email order reminders in the weeks and months leading up to your wedding day. Number six, inviting kids. There are pros and cons when it comes to inviting kids. The pros are that they're really fun to have around. The cons are that sometimes kids can get in the way and disrupt your ceremony or any other events. My husband and I didn't invite kids to our civil ceremony, but we invited kids to our Hindu wedding and also our pre-wedding events. So I suppose that's the benefit to having multiple events. You can choose who you want to invite to different events. Number seven, expect to experience 1,000 emotions. As a bride-to-be, the littlest problems can get you really worked up. For instance, I recall when I got married, my venue coordinator told me that I wasn't allowed to hang things on my outdoor gazebo setting. And I almost cried, but I controlled my emotions and I made sure I didn't turn into a bridezilla, but I just kept really calm about it. The key here is to take some deep breaths and perhaps take some time out from wedding planning altogether. Number 8, not all venues can cater to your needs. My husband and I had this challenge, and I know there are many other couples out there who face similar sort of challenges when it comes to choosing their wedding venue. It's really difficult to convince your venue to allow for the fire ceremony or to allow for external catering. The great thing is, though, that things are slowly changing in this industry. There are more and more venues and caterers who are becoming more accommodating to South Asian brides' needs. They're also becoming aware of the various traditions and steps involved in our wedding. You may still need to do your research though, and if you need someone to point you in the right direction, I'm always here to help. Number 9, customer service will vary between different South Asian wedding vendors. In this digital age, you'd be surprised to know that some South Asian wedding vendors still don't deal with contracts or outline variables. So even if they don't write things down, make sure that you do. Ensure that your vendors are providing the services that are outlined in their contract. And finally, number 10, family photographs will take forever. Your family totally means well, but at the end of the day, your wedding is about you and your partner. Have a list or an order or a schedule and delegate someone such as your wedding coordinator or a friend or a family member to take care of the family photographs. This way you can manage the order in which your family photographs are being taken, no one misses out, and you don't run behind schedule as well. And there you have it. Tell me what your thoughts are and what your biggest takeaways are with regards to this topic. Don't forget to grab the freebie. It's our free wedding planning checklist, and that's in the description below. Once again, press on that subscribe button. Give this video a thumbs up if you love it. And I cannot wait to see you again next week for more wedding planning tips and advice. Thank you so much for watching. See you later.